Hey guys, welcome back. Do you know that you can apply artificial intelligence for your data to get analysis done? By the end of this video, you will be able to learn how to use ideas. That's an AI-enabled feature of an Excel. Effectively for your data to get most analysis done without using single line of code. Even single formula. This video has multiple sections. If you want to skip some of the sections, you can find the links below in the description. You can also find Excel document used in this video under descriptions. So, without further ado, let's get started. Microsoft has been trying to bring artificial intelligence a step closer to its Office users. It has planned for new features that are enabled by artificial intelligence. They are ideas, new data types, insert data from a picture, and dynamic arrays. In this video, we are going to focus on ideas. Ideas is simplified artificial intelligence tool that can be used on large amounts of data. It is an AI-powered insights service that helps people take advantage of the full power of Office. It provides suggestions that are tailored to the task at hand. Ideas helps users create professional documents, presentations, and spreadsheets in less time. For example, in Excel, Ideas helps identify trends, patterns, and outliers in a data set. It helps customers analyze and understand their data in seconds. Even though Ideas is a new feature from Microsoft Office, it is not available to all Office users. Currently, it is available only in Office 365. Even in Office 365, all plans do not have complete features of Ideas. For example, Office 365 Home, Personal, Education, and Business users have basic feature. That means it does not have natural language processing capacity as well as customization option. At the moment, only enterprise users of Office 365 have all full-fledged features of Ideas. For this demo purpose, let us use this sales data. It has bunch of columns like order date, region, representative name, item, units, and unit cost, as well as the price. To use Ideas, data needs to be in tabular form. So just click on any of these cells, either you can press Ctrl T or go to Insert tab and click Table. Just click OK. Once this is done, you just have to go to Home tab and then click on Ideas. That's it. Now Ideas generated set of analysis here. You can scroll down. If you see down, it has 38 more analysis. For example, if you look at it, is saying that price has outliers at order date. You can look at these specific points. If you want, you can actually click on this insert pivot chart, so it will insert the pivot chart here in a new sheet, as well as you can scroll down whatever you think so, and you can just put it down. It's basically a pivot chart analysis. Instead of you selecting the pivot charts, system does automatically some set of pivot charts at its best knowledge. If you still think you can't find what you wanted, you can still go back to pivot chart and do your analysis. If you want to learn more about pivot charts, please find the links in this description that clearly explains how pivot charts needs to be used. As we've seen before, some of the advanced features of ideas is currently available only for enterprise users. At the moment, I'm still working on to get my enterprise version of Excel. For that reason, I'm going to show some of the screenshots in this video. Once I get access to enterprise version, I will make another video to explain in detail. As you see here, when you look at all the suggested or provided list of pivot charts, you should be able to find what you wanted. In case if you do not find what you wanted, you can go here where you can find list of suggested analysis points. You can simply click one of those and you will get the respective analysis. One step further, even if you don't find under suggestion list, you can go back to this text box where you can type your question. When you type question, Excel uses its natural language processing skills and try to answer your question. This is all powered by AI. This should give the results you are expecting. And again, even if you don't find the answer you're looking, that means Excel needs some more training on their machine learning backend. It is continuous process to improve its artificial intelligence engine. Ideas can also be customized. As I said, it is advanced feature. Currently, it is available for only enterprise users. In this customization, you can simply tell Excel that what columns are most important to you and where it should focus its analysis. Usually when you click on ideas, you might be seeing, you know, some bunch of all pivot charts analysis. Maybe they are not relevant to you, or if you are planning to focus only on certain columns, then you can simply say that, okay, can you please focus your analysis on these columns alone. Here on this pane, you will see the gear box icon. When you click on that, you will see a new pop-up showing list of all the fields available in your data table. You can simply select those checkboxes to be included in the analysis. On the right hand side, you can also select what type of analysis you want to be done. For example, in the screenshot, year value is configured as not a value. What that means is we are telling system that this year should be acting as a label. We are not expecting any mathematical operations such as average or sum to be applied on this column. For the sales, we put summarize value by column as a sum. That means we are interested in seeing the value of this sales column to be summarized. That means those values need to be added. And click update. Once you do that, here you will see the analysis done by ideas for you. On top of this, you can also type your own text or question in the text box and you will get analysis done as well. So far, we have learned that ideas is a AI powered tool. It provides analysis, blah blah blah. But if you drill into this one, what type of analysis does it really do? If you closely observe, it provides all this analysis based on pivot charts, pivot table, right? If you look down, all these different analysis, everything is pivot table added with pivot chart. So if you drill down one step deeper, you can find that ideas is providing mainly four types of analysis. One of them is rank. If you look at here, for example, this one, see, usually it is with bar charts or line charts. It basically ranks and highlights the item that is significantly larger than the rest of the items. The second one is trends. As you look at here, one of them, maybe we can find, see, this is also trend, and this one also trend. This is a good example of trend as well. Trends highlights when there is a steady trend pattern or a time series of data. If you look at here, it is basically trying to find trend between rep and unit cost. And the third type of analysis is outliers. See this one. If you look at here, basically it highlights outliers in a time series. If you look at here, as number of units are going up, it is trying to find which one has the price that is not inconsistent with rest of the items. And the fourth analysis is majority. That means it finds cases where a majority of total value can be attributed to a single factor. For example, if you look down here, maybe, yeah, see this one. Item desk accounts for the majority of the price. Usually you can see with these pie charts. So basically, this ideas provides only one of these four analyses. Seen that we can apply ideas to our data set, but can we apply it to any kind of data set? The answer is no. The number one rule is data should be in tabular form and table must be created in Excel. If you look at this data, make sure that it is arranged properly and create a table out of it. You can create a table by clicking Insert tab and click Table, or you can press Ctrl T. Either way works. And make sure that it has labels for a table, and they should be non-blank values. And label should be in one row. They should not spread across two rows. And there should not be any merged cells. And the last one, the table header should have unique values. And if you have very complicated data, you can use Power Query to convert to tables. This time you might have observed that no solution is perfect, no feature is full. Exactly. That is true for even ideas. Ideas has its own limits. It can process the data that has only rows up to 1.5 million. If we have rows more than 1.5 million, it is not suitable. Probably workaround would be to shrink the data to most important fields and create multiple sheets or multiple tables and perform data analysis. And it can only do four types of analysis, as we have seen earlier. If you are looking for something more, then this is not go for you. Microsoft is continuously working to improve, but not sure when we are going to get new features. And even after customization, you may not be able to get some results you wanted. And if you have any date column, that should be formatted as a date. If the date is in text format, and if you are expecting the results for date, you may not get what you wanted. And it is not going to work in Excel compatible mode. That means if you have .xls format, it's not going to work. So what's the workaround? You can simply save it as .xlx or .xlsm or .xslb file. That's all I have for you today. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, please consider subscribing if you would like to see more of this type of content. If you like this video, please like, comment and share. And if you have any questions, concerns or thoughts, don't hesitate to share in the comment section. Thank you for watching.